Now, this project, Seeing Stories, Recovering Urban and Rural Narrative, Landscape Narrative in Europe. The connection between stories and places appears on one level so obvious that you would sort of wonder why we need to explore it or celebrate it. But in actual fact, this connection that is central to all older storytelling traditions has been hugely weakened by the way in which modern society, and particularly the forces of globalization, which is not all necessarily a bad thing, but it has certainly effects on people's sense of connection with place. Now, I have been sort of working with storytellers now for about 40 years. I was probably working with them unconsciously before that, but consciously for about 40 years. And something that has struck me again and again and again is that often the important things about stories are the specific things that connect particular people and events and places and themes. And this actually goes against much of the academic theory about narrative and stories, which emphasizes that which is universal or common. A type of story, for example, that is in many different cultures. And Jung, of course, spoke about archetypes of story and of myths. But although those things are interesting, what actually, in my view, animates, makes the performance of stories, the reception of stories, interesting and important, is that which is absolutely specific and special to that tradition, to that place, to that storyteller. And what I think is that this aspect of storytelling is now becoming much more important. And that is because in culture in general, people are now realizing that if everywhere becomes the same, then everywhere is nowhere. We're living in a nowhere. And we can see that already, particularly in our cities. The modern development makes everything, we might as well be, if we're in Genoa, we might as well be in New York, we might as well be in Moscow. It's just the same. And if everywhere becomes the same place, it becomes nowhere. And why does that matter? Because our identity, our sense of value and meaning, our sense of belonging in a continuum of past and of present and of future begins to dissolve if everywhere is the same place. Then we are just the same people. We're nobody. We're essentially nobody. And I think that people are deeply realizing this and are looking for ways in which they can affirm their sense of identity and connection. And this may be more complex than the past because people may be connected with more than one place. And we have migration and we have travel and we have movement of people, so we may have more of that to come over this next century. Yeah, actually, when we look at the past, we also had migration and travel and movement of peoples. So what I think is that this aspect of storytelling, the sense of place and the connection with places, is now the most important thing in the development of storytelling over the next 20 to 30 years. I think it's the key to where things are going to go. And moreover, I think it's the thing that, because some of you who've been involved in storytelling things and the way that it has, you know, developed again in our contemporary society, can see that in some places storytelling is swallowed up by theatre. It simply becomes a sub-form of theatre, a kind of story theatre. There's nothing wrong with that. It's a form of theatre and it's very, very interesting. But to my mind, that will not preserve the distinctiveness of what is important about storytelling and our traditions. And I think that this sense of connection with environment and with place gives people a vital clue to what is really important in storytelling and to what we should be looking to nurture and develop in the next wave, in order that we can honour all the wonderful traditions that are still living, that people still keep alive, that people have recorded and researched, that we can give that its true respect and value, but also that we can look to a future in which more and more people are being engaged in storytelling and the culture that storytelling carries. And so I do not see this project as a minor matter. I do not see it as one more, you know, European jaunt or whatever, although the jaunts are quite nice, I have to admit. I think this is critical and important, okay? Very critical and important for the future. And I believe that the things we're discussing today, very much at an early stage, are going to grow and develop, and they're going to reach out, because already one has a sense that there are many, many people are interested in these themes and searching. And part of the joy of this will be, you know, as it grows, interacting with more people, with more places, and a truly European movement can emerge and develop, which will link and connect with things that are happening in other parts of the world.